Good morning, Standard 8 students. Now I'm going to teach you the last stanza about how the sun has been personified like a human being. And now the last part is talking about the death of the sun. It does not mean that actually the sun is dead. It is just expressing sunset. So at the end of the day, what activities take place? So here in the last stanza, we are talking about what takes place when a person is dead. Okay. So this line says, then in a wailful choir, wailful means mourning. The choir is singing a sad song. And who's singing? The small gnats moan. Now gnats are small insects as big as a mosquito. And at that part of the day, they start humming. That kind of sound is heard at dusk or after sunset. Where are they found? Among the river sallows. Okay. Now, in the riverside, you have the shallow waters plus the water in the river is murky, mucky, or dirty in simplest form. The water is dirty. And these insects, they breed over these dirty waters. Sallow means dirty or murky waters. There you find these gnats making a noise. So here the poet has compared how a choir sings songs at a funeral. That type of sound is produced by these gnats. Now this is the activity that takes place during the autumn season at dusk. Then pour a knock, O sinking as the light wind lives or dies. Now it is a very sad feeling whosoever has lost a loved one. So the act of sadness prevails over that particular house. In the same way, now sadness is prevailing in the riverside, the hilly areas. As the sun sets, it is that feeling is compared to the feeling when somebody, that sad feeling that somebody loses one, a close relative. So here, the light wind lives or dies. So again here, the wind has been personified. What is the personification? When a non-living object or an abstract idea is given human characteristics, so human behavior. So man lives and dies. Similarly, the fading of the wind. Sometimes you notice at dusk, the weather is absolutely still. There is no wind blowing. Only you can hear the sound of the insects. Then, and full-grown lambs. Now, full-grown lambs are referring to sheep. Loud bleat from hilly bone. Okay, hilly bone. Bone here means it is a small stream. Now, what happens during sunset is all the animals, they go out grazing in the hilly areas. And as the sun is setting, they are returning back home. Okay. So when these sheep are returning, they have got a habit of making a noise while they walk. So that sound of the bleating of the sheep can also be heard when they are crossing a small stream. Then we come to the hedge cricket. Now cricket is also a noisy insect. When it flies, it rubs its wings and produces a ticking sound. So the sound of the crickets can also be heard. But since it is still, so the poet has compared it to and now with treble soft. Treble actually means a high pitch musical note or tone. So that is how the comparison is made. So when there is sadness prevailing over a certain area, so all these things are very soft. Even the music is soft and, you know, very sad, mournful tones could be heard and felt. Then comes the red-breast whistles from a garden croft and gathering swallows twitter in the skies. Now the birds, even when they are going back to their nest, what happens? They also make sounds. Okay. And gradually they take rest in the nest and then they are quiet. That means the day has come to an end. Now the swallows are birds that indicate the summer season. That is why when you see a swallow, then you know the summer season is on. And the entire poetry is based on the mist and the sun, which is very pleasant in the western countries, those areas that live in mid latitudes. So now, I hope you have understood the meaning of Ode to Autumn, where how the season is influenced, or how the place is influenced by the season, right from morning to, or from dawn to dusk, or from sunlight to sunset. Okay. Now I will be sending you the soft copy. Please note down.